God satisfies the desires of your heart, not your flesh. Are you ready for some good news? God wants to grant you the desires of your heart. All you have to do is get in touch with your heart's desires and bring them to God. So, as we continue learning about what it means to pray in the Spirit, we focused on a rich promise in God's Word. Delight yourself in the Lord, and He will give you the desires of your heart, David says in Psalm 37. Also, God is not a magic genie granting the wishes of your flesh. God is too good to give you something bad just because you asked for it. He's a Father who wants fellowship with you that is so intimate that your desires become increasingly conformed to His. Simply put, God wants more for you than you could ever want for yourself. God's intentions towards you are more benevolent than you could imagine. Therefore, it is an expression of God's love that He wants your heart to conform to His. He would like the desires of your heart to become as wonderful as His own desires for your own well-being. In other words, our flesh, and just in our own minds, we dream too small. But your deep, redeemed self, your inmost heart that has been washed by God, has beautiful, sweet, noble desires. That deep, born-again spirit of yours, that heart desires, has desires that outweigh the flesh's desires. And there, in that deep alignment with the truth of God, your heart can bring desires to the Lord that match God's own desires for you. Now, that sort of prayer, the Spirit-enlightened presentation of your blood-washed desires, is the most powerful sort of prayer of all. God draws your best desires back into Himself so that He can demonstrate His love for you by partnering with your intercession to pour out blessing upon you. God doesn't delight in giving you the desires of your sinful nature, the flesh. He delights in giving you the desires of your heart. And in Christ, your heart is clean and new and noble. Thus, the desires of your heart are also God's desires. When you pray that way, God loves granting your desires. It's an extraordinary thought, but surely that's the gospel. Well, that's today's good news. You can get more like it by clicking right here, or better yet, you can subscribe to this channel and make it easy to start out every day with good news.